go again. I gotta pay these bills, save something.
In today's tutorial, I am going to show you how to make your own tapings at home using only one pack of braiding hair that you can get from your local beauty supply store for as little as $2. I'm also going to be showing you guys my bedtime routine as well. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Loveth, and if you are a returning subscriber, like welcome back to my channel.
Today I'm leaning on a song that says everything's gonna be okay, okay. Stop carrying problems through your life. Just let it be, cause everything will happen. So get up on your feet and stop worrying about things.
So for this tutorial, I'm going to use less than a pack of braiding hair, and I'm going to cut it in half, feather it out, and brush the hair through until it looks like this. Next, I'm going to take my baking paper, cut out the amount that I need, and secure it to my table using cello tape. And this is just going to ensure that the entire process of, you know, making our DIY tapings doesn't mess up my table. So now that I'm done with that, I'm going to divide my hair into 6 equal parts. And that's because I'm going to be making 6 bundles of hair. Using my measuring tape and a marker, I'm going to measure 48 cm and mark it down on the baking paper, and this is going to be the length of each bundle. Next, I'm going to evenly spread out the hair within the mat area, and because the hair kept slipping off, I decided to use something to secure it until I had arranged the hair to my desire. Guys, I do have a little bit of cold, so if I sound a little bit off, please bear with me. Using my cello tape, I'm going to tape the hair down to the baking paper about 2 inches away from the beginning, like so. And now to the star of the show. So while cracking my head up for weeks on how to break the code on this, I decided to try this B6000 multipurpose adhesive, and this right here, baby, is liquid gold. It is clear in color, it is flexible, and most importantly, it is waterproof. So now I'm going to go ahead and apply the adhesive glue to the edge of the cello tape as a guide, and this is just going to ensure that our glue is applied neatly and in a straight line. I'm also going to use the back side of a comb like so and press the glue down so that it gets distributed evenly. I got this from my local beauty supply store for 600 naira, which is less than a dollar, and this stuff right here will have your attachment or braiding hair glued to the guts. So now that I'm done applying the adhesive to the hair, I'm going to let it sit overnight until it is completely dry. So now our hair is completely dry, and I'm going to go in with our second star of the show, double-sided tape. Guys, when I looked online, I discovered that the regular expensive $1 million tapings that have been around for some time are usually 4 cm long and 1 cm wide per piece. So I got this 1 cm wide double-sided tape for 800 naira, which is about $1. So I'm going to align the edge of the double-sided tape with the edge of the cello tape, and then take the cello tape off. Next, I'm going to take a ruler and make a mark on the double-sided tape at 4 cm intervals. And girl, this is just going to ensure that our tapes are equal when I cut them.
I saw those girls laughing at the way you are. Don't let some girls stop you from reaching.
Once I'm done with that, I'm going to remove the hair from the parchment paper, cut off the excess hair like so, and also cut the bundle at the marked areas. And because we cut each piece of hair at 4 cm while our bundle was 48 cm long, each bundle made 12 tapings. So now to give them that, you know, extra factory finish and rounded professional look, I'm going to place 4 tapes together and cut the edges like so to make cutting it easier while saving time. And guys, our tapings are ready. Like, this is so easy to do, and if I can do it, then you can also do it as well.
Blue jeans, go ahead, let the world see your life.
it's time to put a DIY to test. It's time to install them. So on this day, I had just washed my hair and I was trying to stretch it a little when I noticed that there was a fly in the room and I wasn't having it. So to cut the long story short, I said, screw you fly, and ended up filming the tutorial the next day. If you look closely, you'll notice that my nails were different and I tried to make my makeup look just as it looked the previous day, okay? To stretch my hair, I used my Remington Keratin Protect hair brush, and let me tell you, I love the fact that it has a very hot setting, a medium setting, and then a cool setting if you don't want like heat at all. So literally all my life, I have suffered from severe dandruff and psoriasis, which leaves my scalp extremely dry and flaky if it is not properly moisturized after I wash my hair. However, because I saw people mention that if you want to, you know, get taping, you shouldn't oil or apply conditioner to your hair, so I didn't. While I was parting my hair, I just couldn't, okay? I just couldn't ignore the flakes. So I went in and applied my favorite leave-in conditioner in the world, which is the Vital Olive Oil Anti-Breakage Leave-In Conditioner. This leave-in conditioner is water-based, it moisturizes and detangles your hair, it helps prevent breakage, and most importantly, it provides heat protection, which is amazing because I'll be flat ironing my hair. And let me tell you something, my tapings didn't slide off until I was ready to take them off. So I did leave out the perimeter of my hair like so because my intention was to wear this hairstyle either in a ponytail or in a bun. I also decided to flat iron my hair as I go, you know, just to avoid doing it over and over. Now the whole idea about applying tape-ins is just imagine a sandwich or a burger. So see your bun as your tape-in. You have one side of the bun that has the mayo and all of that. That's the sticky side. And then see your hair as your meat, your veggies and all of that. And then see the other side of the tape-in as the top of the bun, okay, that has the mayo. And the mayo is like the sticky side. So the entire idea of, you know, tape-ins is basically you sandwiching a thin layer of your hair in between two tapes. Once you get the concept, install it. The hair will be easy breezy. Installing that first tip in was a big struggle. Like, I almost felt like I had just wasted my time because I just could not place it right. So after trying for several minutes, I decided to place the sticky side of the tip in horizontally to the tip of my rat tail comb, and that was it. Once I did that, I took off the comb, attached it to the second tip in, this time with the sticky side facing inwards, and I placed it on top of my hair. I also gave the tip ins a good press, and finally, our DIY tip in was in. I also went ahead with a flat iron that wasn't so hot and, you know, pressed the hair together. So I went ahead and installed the second tip in. However, I kind of like discovered that it was just too close to the first one, but I was like, you know what, I'm not taking this out because having it installed was a struggle. Like, this was my first time trying out tip ins and I was literally just winging it out one tip in at a time. Installing the rest of the hair was easy breezy because I had gotten the hang of it by this time. I just took out like a section of my hair, flat ironed it, took out a piece of hair and sandwiched it between two tape-ins, and that was it. So I'm going to go ahead and allow you guys to watch how I install the hair and I'll be right back. Please go ahead and hit that subscribe button and turn on your notifications because trust me, you will not want to miss the next tutorial. We are almost at 250,000 subscribers and I would really love to have you as part of the Lovethspeaks family. Not today, I can't have fun. Too busy trying to figure out how to make my dreams become reality. That's what I chase. Every day I'm older than the last and I don't have the time to waste. So just maybe one day, baby, we'll be there at the top, baby. Like the 4th of July, you're the big surprise. Oh, that ain't no lie. But that means no slipping tonight. Something. didn't use one full pack of hair, and that's why the hair didn't look really, really full. My intention was to wear this in a ponytail and in a bun, so I wasn't really bothered with, you know, the fullness of the tapes, okay? Get my always try on. I gotta get my hit the gym on. Get my sink or swim on. I gotta get it. 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 Gotta get my don't complain on. Gotta get my win this game on. I gotta get my don't sit still on. Get my pay these bills on. I gotta get my Jasper Sawyer on. Don't say my name. Say your own. I gotta get it. I also went in with a flat iron that wasn't too hot, like so, just to get more security. And I did this to every single piece of the tapings that I had installed on my hair. So this hair lasted for so long, and I did have a few pieces come off here and there. And what I did to salvage that was I just reapplied the double-sided tape to the piece that came off, and that was it. This right here was the hair after 2 weeks, like 2 freaking weeks. At this point, I was just starstruck at my own invention. I haven't seen anyone doing this on YouTube, so if you try recreating this, please give me some credits, like, hey, this tutorial was inspired by Lovethspeaks, okay? I also know that some of you by now will be wondering, like, Loveth, how do you take this out? Don't worry, I also filmed like how to take the hair down, but because I didn't want this tutorial to be so long, I was like, I'm going to put that in a separate video. It's going to come up after this upload, so make sure you turn on your notifications, like hit that bell button if you're not subscribed to my channel, just so you don't miss when I upload the takedown part of this tutorial. For now, it's time to show you guys my bedtime routine. On this day, God was just showing off. Look at that glow, like, whoo, the skin and the makeup was given. So for my bedtime routine, I'm going to show you guys three options. For option one, I'm going to be using this satin head wrap that I got on AliExpress for $1.99, and I've had this for so long, and this is like my go-to bedtime routine. So yeah, I'm going to put the link to this in the description box of this tutorial. Yes, I'm up. I can't sleep tonight. I'm too busy trying to figure out how to make tomorrow right. It's too soon to celebrate. For option two, I'm going to be using this perforated head net that I got from my local beauty supply store for 300 naira, and I'm going to use it along with a scarf. Now, even though the hair net alone stays in place, using this scarf will prevent my natural fussy hair from, you know, reverting. It's going to make sure that by the time I wake up in the morning, my hair remains silky straight, like I just had the fresh silk press, okay? For option three, I'm going to be using this big satin scarf, and I'm going to bend it to form a triangle and tie my hair down like so. This option is also very easy and keeps my hair flat till whenever I'm ready to take it off, and I'm pretty sure that you have a scarf in your house. Okay guys, that's it for today's tutorial. I'm sorry this tutorial was so long. I just wanted it to be as detailed as possible, okay? Please make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel and turn on the bell icon, okay? So you'll be the first to get notified when I upload the takedown parts. I hope you guys found this tutorial helpful. Please comment down below any trendy hairstyle that you'd like me to create. Also, give this video a big thumbs up and share it with your friends and your loved ones. And I'll see you guys in my next tutorial. Till then, bye guys. Yeah.